Hi everyone, let's get started with our new tutorial. In this tutorial, we'll be focusing mainly on creating an attribute view on SAP HANA. So to start with, let's open the HANA Studio. Let me double click on this. Okay, once we are in the HANA Studio, the first thing that we are going to do is we are going to the modeler perspective. So go to the open perspective, click on other, and you will see the modeler over here. Now we are in the modeler perspective. So in the modeler perspective, what we need to do is we need to go to the left side, select our system, and under the catalog, we will be going to our schema, which is efashion_tutorial. So we will be seeing what tables we have in this particular schema. We have these tables, these are the dimension tables, and this is the fact table. Now for this tutorial, we'll be focusing mainly on creating an attribute view. So let's get started. Attribute view normally we create on a dimension table. Okay, so let's create. To go to the attribute view, what we need to do is we need to first create a package. Okay, what we do in package is we are clubbing all the attribute view, the analytic view, the calculation view in a single container, which is called as package. Okay, let's create a package. Now the package is created. This package is empty, there is nothing there in that. So to get started, let's create an attribute view in this. Okay, let's create an attribute view. So we will create an attribute view on the article. Okay, so now we see that okay, these are the different schemas available. We'll go to the table which is having the article. Okay, this is the article lookup table that we'll select. We'll click on add, and our table is over here. That's it. Okay, so this is the article attribute view that we have created, and it is on table article. Okay, on the extreme right side, you can see the article over here. We have attribute, calculated attribute, and hierarchies. Everything is empty. Now to populate them, what we'll do is we will on the center, what you are seeing is you are seeing the different columns which are available in this particular table. Okay, so what we'll do is let's select this as the key attribute. Okay, and let's add rest of the columns as the other attributes. So let me use a shift button and add them as an attribute. Okay, once we are done with this, we can check whether everything is okay or not. We can just save it and validate. At the bottom, you can see the message that it is completed successfully, so there are no errors in that, and we can activate this right now. So it looks good. Okay, one more thing that we need to validate is we need to make sure that we have granted the permission for this particular schema. Okay, so to do that, what we'll do is let me show you how we can grant the permission. So these are the two statements that we'll be using to grant the permission. Okay, if we don't grant the permission, we'll be seeing some errors, something like this, that is insufficient privileges on this particular schema. So to avoid this, we need to make sure that we are granting the select on schema this to sys_repo with grant option. Okay, so let's get started. Let's create a, let's open the SQL editor, and we will execute these two commands in that, and we'll go to the details of what this command are and what for we use this. Okay, let's paste it on this particular editor. Okay, the first command is grant select on schema system. So we have this, this is the schema system. Okay, and to this particular user, because internally it uses this user for doing the work, so we need to grant permission to this particular user on this schema. Second thing is we need to grant for this particular schema to make sure that it can select, it can read this table from this schema. So we need to grant the select access as well for this particular schema. So this is one thing that you may need to take note of it. Okay, so you can see that the statement is executed without any errors. Okay, let's go to the attribute view. Now we have created the attribute view. You can see that these are the, this is the key attribute, these are the other attributes in this particular attribute view, and at the center you can see that okay, this is the table on which the attribute view is created. Now to check to make sure that we have the data, let's click on the data preview to see the data there. Okay, you can see the data is created. You can see the data is here. Okay, that's all. Thanks everyone for joining. Bye-bye.